Hello everyone and welcome to the session 1 of unit 4 drilling and milling machine for the course 15ME43T machine tool technology. Myself Muhammad Imran, lecturer in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Government Polytechnic, Karwa. So in the today's session we are discussing the introduction to drilling machines and radial drilling machines. So the drilling machine, you can see in the figure, it is primarily intended to produce the holes in any workpiece. So drilling machine is a machine tool which is used to drill the holes and similar operations related to holes related operations, such as maybe tapping operation, maybe reaming operation, it may be boring operation. So and similar operation on the components of the workpiece with the help of drill bits. So the tool used for producing drill or holes is known as a drill bit. You can see in the figure, this is the drill bit. So with this tool we are making the holes. The holes were first drilled by Egyptians in the year 1200 BC, 300 years ago, by this period, by means of bow pins. So that is the sharp edge of the bows, arrows and bows, which is used for making the drilling. Drilling operation. Later on, the development leads to the development of this drilling machine. So the drilling machine mainly consists of the following parts. This is a table, you can see. So it is used to hold the workpiece, and this is the drill bit which is used to produce the drilling operation, and this is the chuck which holds the drill bit, and these are drill heads and everything. These are the motors which produce the rotary motion to the drill bit. So these are the clamps for reducing and decreasing the height of the workpiece, and this is the base. So the drilling machine, so the drill bit used maybe a following type, you can see in the figure. So it is a multi-point cutting tool. So unless the lathe operation which is done by single point cutting tool, so here the drill bit consists of multi-point cutting tools. You can, so these are all our cutting points, cutting edges. So these are in operation at a time when the machining operation takes place. So drill bit are also called as multi-point cutting tools. Multi-point cutting tools, you know that what is the difference between single point and multi-point cutting tools, which I have already discussed. Single point has a single cutting edge in action during the machining operation, whereas the multi-point cutting tool has a several cutting edges which is are in action at a time, such as this drill bit, maybe milling cutter. So the metal removal rate are very higher compared to the single point cutting tool, because more cutting edges are in action at a time. So the metal removal rate, that is called as the rate at which the metal is removed from the workpiece, MRF, is higher in case of a multi point cutting tool. So thereby increases the decreases the production time and increases the efficiency of the production. So types of drilling machine. So we have different types of drilling machine. So this is you have already seen in the any your day-to-day uses. So these are available in your houses also. So this is known as portable drilling machine. So why it is called portable means it can be easily transferred to any places. It can easily take it to any places and you can drill. So that's why it's called as portable. So you can transfer, or you can transfer this to any places, or you can carry this this machine to anywhere and you can drill. So you can use it in your house for daily drilling purposes. So next is sensitive drilling machine. So this drilling machine you usually see in the workshops. So this is heavier in construction. This is fixed in position. Unlike this portable drilling machine, you cannot carry it into the any places. It is as a base which is installed into a particular fixed place. So next is we have upright drilling machine, you can see in the figure. So this is the radial drilling machine. So it will discuss later in the deeply this about the radial drilling machine. So this is a gang drilling machine. So you can see more than one spindle at a time. We can drill more than one workpieces at a time using gang drilling machine. So multi-spindle drilling machine. You can see this. There are number of spindles here. So multi-spindle drilling machine. So this is automatic drilling machine using CNC machining operations. So if using a computer numeric control, we can operate this drilling machine. So next is deep hole drilling machine. So it is a special purpose machine which is mainly used for producing deep hole in the workpiece where required. So next is radial drilling machine. So radial drilling machine, you can see in the figure, consists of the following part. So this is the radial arm. So that's why it is called as radial drilling machine. Why it is called radial drilling machine? Because this radial arm can be rotated along a swing along the particular radius. So that's why it is called radial drilling machine. You can move this arm along the radial direction. That's why it is called as the radial drilling machine. So this type of machine is mounted on the floor. So it is mounted on the floor and installed to a fixed place and suitable for drilling medium to large and heavy workpiece. It is suitable for drilling medium to large heavy workpieces. We can handle the medium, large and heavy workpieces in the radial drilling machine because it has the ability to drill along the widely radial area. So it consists of a vertical column. So this is the vertical column. So with an arrangement to rise and lower the revolve the ram. So we can this radial arm can be moved up and down using this vertical arm, and also we can swing this arm along the radial direction with the help of this vertical column. This arrangement helps to accommodate jobs of different heights, and radial arm can swing to any position above the weight. So this radial arm, you can see this is called as radial arm. So this radial arm can swing along the radial direction. So it helps to accommodate the large workpiece, so that can be drilled at any radial position of this arm. So the radial drilling machine is used to drill the holes in the given radial distance when the component size is larger and in terms of height with respect to the work table. So with respect to the table, if the component size is higher than the work table, so we can mount it on the floor and we can drill using the radial arm, which can be swing along the radial direction. So we can accommodate any larger workpieces with this arrangements. So when the component is large, it cannot fit into the structure in the wall. So you can see this voice is very small. The component is heavy and larger. We cannot accommodate this workpiece on this table or voice. So in that case, the component has to be placed on the ground. You can see it can be placed on the ground, and this arm, this vertical radial arm, can be swing to any direction like this. So if the component is having the drilling surface here, so we can swing this radial arm like here, and we can drill here. We can lower and raise on this arm with the help of this vertical arm. Therefore, the component has to be placed on the ground, and the radial arm of the drilling machine has to be rotated with respect to component to do the operation. So these are the important parts of the radial drilling machine: base, column, radial arm, motor for elevating arm, elevating screw, motor for drying spindle, drill head, drill spindle, and table. You can see the base. This is the base, and this is the column. It's also known as the vertical column. And this is the radial arm. Why it is called radial? Because it has in a radial direction. You can see motor for elevating the arm. So there is another special motor to lift this arm automatically. So next, elevating screw. Elevating screw, motor for drawing the spindle. This is the motor for rotating the spindle, and this motor is for rotating the rising and lowering this radial arm. Drill head, so this is the drill head which consists of gears and everything to change the speed of the spindle. Drill spindle, so this is the drill spindle. Table, so this is the table upon which the work is placed. Base, so it is made up of cast iron which possesses high compressive strength and good wear resistance. The base is used to support the assembly of the parts on it and absorb the vibration induced on the machine. So the base is made up of cast iron. It is heavier in construction, so it is having good wear resistant and everything, and it is also having good vibration resistance. Why? Because all these characteristics, because it has to handle the heavy and larger workpiece continuously. So so in order to hold everything, this strength and the weight of the workpiece, it has to be made good high wear resistance and vibration resistance. So column, so it is exactly placed at the end of the bed, which can act as a supporting for the rotating radial arm in 360 degrees. So this is the column. So this is it fixed at the end of this base. This is the base. So end of this base is vertical column is started. It can support the rotating radial arm in 360 degrees radial arm. So this supports the radial arm. So this column is used to support the radial arm, which can be rotated at a 360 degrees like this. So this radial arm can be rotated with a radial direction like this, 360 degrees. So which is supported by this column. With the help of this column only, this radial arm is rotated. It is the arm that is connected to the column. The drill head is slid from one end to the another end by this guide wheel. So you can see the drill head. So it is having the radial arm is having the guide wheel upon which this drill head can be moved like this in a linear direction in order to accommodate the length of the workpiece. So this drill head can be moved along this longitudinal direction by the guides provided in the radial arm. The motor, it is placed on the drill head for drawing the workpiece. You can see this is the motor. This is a separate motor. This is a separate motor. This motor is used for the rotation of the spindle. So inside this we have various gear mechanism to speed the to change the speed of this spindle. The machine wise is connected to the swivel table that can hold the workpiece for further operation. Flywheel or hand wheel. So this is the hand wheel or flywheel. It is connected to spindle arrangement. It is used to move up and down with respect to the workpiece. So this arm hand wheel is used to move the spindle up and down in order to do the give the feed. So with respect to this workpiece, there are different mechanism inside this. So this wheel is used to give the feed towards downward direction and to lift this spindle in upward direction after the work drilling operation is done. Drive head, it is generally consists of two levers, which by varying can increase or decrease the speed of the chuck. So drive head, you can see this. This is the drive head, which is used to vary the speed of the spindle. Chuck. So chuck, as usual, it is used to carry the one end of the chuck is connected to the spindle arrangement, and another end is connected to the drill bit. So one end of the chuck is connected to the spindle, and other end is connected to drill bit. So one end is connected to chuck is connected to spindle. Other end is connected to drill. So chuck is used to hold the drill bit, and also it is used to connect the spindle. So it is an arrangement which is connects the drill bit with the spindle. So these are the some important components, important parts of the radial drilling machine. So why it is called radial drilling machine? Because it has a radial arm, so which can be swiveled along the radial direction in order to accommodate the heavier or larger workpiece. So these are mainly used in industries because of its ability to cover the heavy and larger workpiece. It is widely used in the mechanical engineering industry. So thank you for this session. So in next session we'll come with the next operations, different operations of the drilling machine, etc. Thank you for watching this session.